Good morning, students. Today, with the complete series of complex analysis, again we are study about the analytical function. Analytical function, I told you that one is the most important condition that it is follow the CR equation. So, myself, Dr. Gauri Sharma, assistant professor, mathematics. Again, still we are objective to understand the analytical function and complex circle and property of analytical function. After this completion, we will solve some question. It takes a cube. So students, thank you. This is very interesting session. Now I come to the lecture. First, yesterday we have discussed about analytical function. If function is called analytical, a complex function f z is equal to u plus iota v is called analytical if it is follow the CR equation. But this is the necessary condition for a, this is necessary condition, not a sufficient condition. Okay, students. So here we will take del u upon del x is equal to del v upon del y. This is a Cauchy equation one, and second is del u upon del y equal to minus del v upon del y. This is the second equation, Cauchy equation. Now we just talk about harmonic equation, harmonic function. A function is called harmonic. It follows some condition. Follow condition means del square u upon del x square plus del square u upon del y square is equal to 0. Where u is the real part. Fz is equal to u plus iota. Now we take example that prove that uxy ekx cos y is harmonic function. So find conjugate also. Analytical conjugate. So student, in this there are two questions. First, we have to prove that this is harmonic, and second, we will find conjugate for harmonic function. Harmonic function. tell you must be 0. So here u is equal to this. So we take u is equal to e to the power x cos y. So del u upon del x e to the x cos y. Del to u upon del x square e to the x cos y. Del g upon del y is equal to minus e to the x sin y. Del square v upon del x del y square is equal to minus e to the x. So we see that this is harmonic. This is harmonic because del square u upon del x square plus del square v upon del y. Now v is equal to by del u upon del x. So del u upon del x is equal to e to the power x cos y del v upon del y. So dv is equal to, and we just do the integration of this, we will get the value of v, and v is the conjugate of u. So we can easily find out v and u. This is already, I think, we done. Now we move some more example, and some important question. Now we move to Milani function construction method. Milani function construction method. What is this method? This is also a method to find out the analytical function. This is a method to find out the analytical function. See Milani function structure. Let fz is equal to, we take fz is equal to uz0 plus iota here. We put W is equal to fz is equal to u plus iota. Fz is equal to del u upon del x plus iota del v upon del x. Okay. We know that del v upon del x is equal to, we can say, del u upon del x minus iota del u upon. We take, as we take value upon del x is equal to pi epsilon, and वैल्यू ऑन द लेफ्ट माइनस देन इक्वल टू बिकम वाई एक्स वाई x y minus theta. Here we put x is equal to z now integrate now we take the example of this, how to find out the analytical function when one part is given. Let prove that to use the e to power x x cos y minus y sin y x cos y minus y satisfy Laplace equation. Laplace equation and find conjugate and find analytical function. Okay, in this question we find that b u is equal to e to power x x cos y minus y sin y. So this is by Laplace equation and find analytical function. We need to find out the u and v for make an analytical function. We know that f z is equal to in the form of u plus iota v. Now the proof, what is the proof? Del u upon del x. We have to find out del u upon cos y plus e to power x y minus y. This is equation number one. But we need del square u upon del v square. Then y square 40 du upon dy is equal to u is equal to e to the power x. Here you write e to the power x x cos y y sin y. This is our x. This is our u, sorry. So del u upon del y, we have to differentiate u with respect to y. So e to the power x minus x sin y again we d sin y plus y cos y plus e to the power x cos y y sin y. We can solve with e to the power x sin y del y e to the power x minus x and y minus minus sin y and minus y cos. This is the value of del u upon del y. Del square u upon del y. E to the power x minus x sin ka differentiation cos y minus cos y minus y cos y minus cos differentiation minus sin cos. This is our, so we can say e to the power x minus x cos y minus 2 cos y by adding equation 1 and 2, we get by adding equation 1 and 2, we find now this equation. Now by adding we get, so we conclude that the function is in harmonic. Now we will find the position. For this, that u upon that minus del u upon del x equal del u upon del x e to power x e to power x cos by e to power x y e to power x x cos by minus y sin. E to power x x cos y minus y. Minus y del u upon del y. Del u upon del y e to power a minus x and y and y minus sin y minus y sin. Now we put x is equal to z and y is equal to z. So x is equal to z e to the power z cos y cos 0 is equal to 1 plus e to the power z cos y 1 is equal to z and y put 0 and sin y 0 so it is equal to minus I term e to the power z e to the power z sin 0 0 for this number this is also zero. So this is become 1 this is our now integrating both sides. This is z e to the power z plus power z e to the power z. Now this is our analytical method. This is analytical. If there is asking about the conjugate, we can use the CR equation, but this is the direct method to find out the analytical function. So we use Mulliani construction method. Okay, friends. Now, another example we take, this is very important. Back value of which value of that the function is not on. W 1 plus z rich value this is. So for find this is analytical for which value we simply differentiate this. We simply differentiate the value now 1 minus z here, 1 minus z as it is, this become 1 minus 1 plus z is become minus 1. Minus minus plus 1 so 1 minus z now it cancels become 1 minus z now this function is not analytical when the function is not exist. And which value this function is not exist? We see this function is not exist. We have z is equal to 1. If z is equal to 1, we put in this, this convert in the infinity. So, at z minus 1 is equal to 0, then function not exist. That means z is equal to 1, the function is not this function is not. Similarly, to find the function is not analytical, just differentiate the function with respect to z. If we differentiate the function, we get the term in 1 upon z, z minus 1, z minus 2 half square, then the function is not a. If the value of z is equal to 1 in this question, the function converts in the infinity. The function not exist. That means at the point z is equal to 1, the function is not analytical. This is very important. So again, I take another example to understand this concept. Because in many exams, many exams for CSNET, IIT JAM, and IIFR, in this exam, just asking about where find the value of z of which place. The function is not analytical. So this is the important part. Z is equal to e to the power minus x minus cos u plus iota sin. So this is our w. We take del z upon del u first. E to minus b, sorry, this is e to power minus b. In term of e to power minus b, this convert cos u is equal to convert minus sin u, and this is sin u plus iota. Now we multiply the term I delta I e to the power minus b it becomes might assign you minus cos u. It can also be write like that, eta e to the power minus k minus cos u plus eta sin u. Okay, so this can be write as e to the power eta u. In this form we see this is eta del z. Z is equal to given e to the power minus b minus cos u plus eta sin u. We just differentiate that with respect to u. So this becomes e to the power minus b sin u cos u become minus sin u. So sin minus minus plus sin u then plus eta cos u. Then we multiply with eta, so this eta converts in the minus sign. So this is converted e to the power z form. E to the power z form. Now we get we can write now. Z upon del z dw, we can say this dz upon dw upon dz is equal to 1 upon eta. Okay, so we multiply with eta, so we get eta z. Here this term is can be assumed as 1 upon z. So this will be converted in infinity when z is equal to 0. So at z is equal to 0, the function is not analytical. Not analytical, because when you put z is equal to 0, the function, the value of dw upon dz is converted into infinity. And we know by the above example, when the z, which value of z converts the function in infinity, this is a not be analytical, not be exist. Function is not exist there, so which is not exist, so function is not exist at that is. Now student, I give you some example for your practice. That is equal to sin hyperbola u cos v plus eta cos hyperbola u for which value of the function is not exist. Now I'm writing important example for you. You should be try for that. That is equal to you. U plus eta v is an analytical function of last when this is the time for cure. We continue with the cure. Which is the analytical function? The question fz is equal to e to the power x cos y, fz is equal to e to the power x sin y, both and not. So both function you should be try or by yourself that which of the fulfill the, which function is fulfill the Cauchy-Riemann equation, condition of Cauchy-Riemann equation. So e to the power x cos y and e to the power x sin x, I think both are the analytical function. Okay. Which is the CR equation instead? U is equal to, is not a CR equation. Del U upon del V, del Y is equal to minus del V upon del X. This is the CR equation. So you see the B and C option is very similar. So student more confused in that. But B is the right answer because minus, you see the minus sign. And complex function is analytical if only satisfies CR equation, follow CR equation, differentiate at each point. D, P and C are both conditions should be fulfilled for the analytical condition that the function differentiate at each point of the contour. In polar form, Z can be written on cycle with the Z is equal to, okay, this is the repeating question, angle and if z is equal to 1, z is equal to 1 means radius is 1. So A or B both are the right option. A function is in the form of u plus iota v, then it is a complex function, v is a conjugate function, all points are differentiable, all of these. It is a complex function, right. And all points are differentiable. If the R points are differentiable, then it is analytical. So all points are right of this question. So student, now, thank you very much.